You there? Could you help us out, Cully?
Kind of funny when I see the frame rate drop to such a degree where it kind of reminds me of Alone in the Dark or original Resident Evil. PS4, yes. Ah, that's where that processing boost comes in. Okay. Yes, what soda is it again? Yeah.
The cardboard cutout of
Devin Booker. Yes. Yeah. Clay's gonna start a separate character too. Same class though. Right, yeah. Yes, Clay's gonna start a different character, but the same class, and it will be for me to show him, what to do so he doesn't feel so lost. He got your message, too. Ha, oh, sweet, another chest. A great axe. That's not for me. Yeah, that's true. You can, like, reset yourself back to zero and then use all the souls. No, they're referring to builds right now. Like how you, level up your character to fit your playstyle. I picked up a great axe, and I just cracked something about that being not for me. But of course, you know, just like in Dark Souls 1, you can, like, reset yourself back to zero and use the, souls, to, like, reconfigurate your stats. Though, if you want to know what really sucks, though, Carniel, imagine dying right after you reset your souls. Ah, that's even better. Taking out these guys. They were mining or something. Well, I only use the sword when I, when I run out of magic. Or to conserve magic. Vice versa, you know. One of those two. I guess that kind of makes me a little like Gandalf, you know? Like, you know, doesn't Gandalf, like, use a sword? Glamadrine? Glamma. I think it's called Glamadrine. It's definitely a mithril weapon. Oh, yeah, where he got knocked down after saying you shall not pass, right? Oh yeah, it was in Hobbit. I'm sorry. Yeah.
6 more billion hobbit house
I once. I once did a challenge for my Facebook. I wasn't allowed to post anything except Hobbit related stuff, and I had to post a Hobbit related thing for like each day for like 150 days straight or something like that. And then it later got extended to like 2 years. So now, according to my friend, Clay, it's 2 billion years I got to. So it's now like a Scientology task. The Sea Org, you know, the apparent. Yeah. Okay. I wanna like. Can I deposit my souls first? Spirit spring jumping. Jump while on horseback near the spirit spring to ride its current high in the air. You won't take damage from jumping. Okay, I think I can do this. I see it. Okay. Okay. Castle Morn Rampart, is that where you are?
Selling.
Okay, I see him. I guess I touched the wrong one. Oh, no, I meant the what's it called again? This glowy thing? The grace. I touched the wrong grace. They mentioned some other grace that I had to get to using my horse, which I think I need to fly up a current with or something like that. Yeah, I have a horse. The steed. Yeah. How do I access that menu again for, like, the quick, okay, press start triangle, and then up, okay. Oh, okay. I see now, I got it. Someone's throwing rocks. Okay, I'm following you. Yeah. think he only gave me 1,000 runes, though. You're right, it isn't. Liar ahead. I remember when I read messages in that in Dark Souls, like that in Dark Souls, there's like they were referring to an NPC that was going to like betray me later on. Oh yeah, that's the other thing. Sometimes it's like they put it before false doors, but they didn't know the best word to like describe it. Imagine a world where people speak with limited Dark Souls messages. You go to church and everybody says, "Praise, son!" It's okay, I survived. Okay. have one. I think that's the only one I have. I'll see if I can like adjust what I can do. Oh, there they are. Yeah. Oh yeah, there they are. There we go. And these golem-like guys, I noticed, now I started to notice, they actually look a little more like harpies. So it's like thug life, but the hate you give little infants fouls everybody. Yeah. Yeah. It's also like Tupac's clever catchphrase. Thug Life. It's like, it on surface level, it sounds like if someone just says Thug Life, it sounds like it's like, yeah, douchey or celebratory of gangster nastiness. But in actuality, it's just saying, you know, people treat me terribly, and now we're like in a vicious cycle.
There's a face I've not seen before. I'm Edgar, warden of this castle, as ordained by Lord Godric himself. But you can see how things have turned out. The menials have all rebelled. They gave me good service, or so I thought. But it seems it was all an act. Foul creatures, as it said, and true enough, they're foul inside and out. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but whatever you come here to do, I'm afraid Castle Morn won't hold much longer. Take this, by way of apology.
A sacrificial twig. Was he talking about the little harpy monkey men that we just, you know, slaughtered? Yeah. That's all I got. Need to get from him, right? That sacrificial twig. Okay. Like enemy against enemy. A chest where again? Oh, right there. Claymore. Praise the armament. I got a claymore. Okay, on your lead. Oh, right. Another item. A steel wire torch. Ah, should I climb up there? Smithing stones. Ah, one of these things. Good. Guess I should take this as a sign to level up, huh? I'll do that. All right, I see it now. I'm summoning. I changed out my short sword for now a long straight sword.